Hi everybody, today I got something a bit unusual for my channel. I was inspired by a Seth Bling video that he uploaded 2 days ago about a sequential combo lock. I built up Seth Bling's design over here and I quickly want to explain what it does. So this door will only open if a code is entered. And there's also no reset button, so you can start entering the code at any moment. So let's quickly do that. H2 1 2 3 3. And the door will open. So what I found most fascinating about Seth Bling's video is that he kinda stuck to using old school redstone components. So he only used repeaters, redstone dust, and also redstone torches. This is actually stuff that got added in the alpha and beta versions of the game. So before I actually started playing, I started playing in Minecraft 1.5. And I checked, he also uses the locked repeater features, which was added in 2012, so in Minecraft 1.4. Yeah, so it was really fascinating. So this technically could have been built 7 years ago and would have worked. A lot of the old school redstone videos I watched when I started playing Minecraft were about contraptions like this one here that involve a lot of logic gates, because the components were just made for it, with the redstone dust as a wire, repeaters for delay, and the redstone torch, which is essentially a NOT gate. I thought it would be a nice challenge to try to recreate Seth Bling's design, but without using any of the components he used. So without the old school redstone torch, repeater, and redstone dust. Okay, that's what I did over here. It's definitely a lot more colorful. Here we can also see the palette of blocks that I used. So we got the 1.14 composter, the redstone block from 1.5, slime block from 1.8. Then we also have leaves and logs for the new leaf store mechanic, which was added in Minecraft 1.13. Okay, we got the pistons, which were also added in beta, but it would have been hard to do without pistons. Then we got the dropper and hopper from 1.5, the observer from 1.11. Then also another replacement for redstone dust. You can also use rails as a wire. I also had to use a redstone lamp for some observer delay. Node block, which got new functionality in Minecraft 1.13. We also need to use the glazed terracotta and also the comparator, which was added in Minecraft 1.5. So now I want to show you that I got a working version as well. Here you can see the code that we need to enter. So one. It's definitely a bit noisier. 1 1 2. And 2. And the door opens. Alright, if I press now another button and we don't have the correct code anymore, then the door also closes. So next one, I explain you how my combo lock works and how I replace some of the redstone mechanics that Seth Bling used. So my design works the same as Seth Bling's, but I just replace some of the components. Alright, first the information storage. I think Seth Bling called this a shift register, but I'm not as familiar with those technical terms than Seth Bling is. So basically we store information if a button is pressed or not and shift over by one. So that's the idea. So Seth Bling used the repeater locks here. So this lever is now the particles. I think it's turned on. Yep. Alright, so this basically simulates a button being pressed, and then the first repeater also gets a signal. And this is stored by using the repeater lock mechanic. As you can see, it's getting shifted over. And I would turn this off now. Actually, then everything gets shifted over by one. And that's how we cycle through the whole chain, and information is stored. So the idea is this would be the line for one of the button presses. So if I press 1, for example, then here we get a signal in the repeater. And if I press another button, then this line here in the back still unpowers. And also everything is shifted over, but the information is stored that this button wasn't pressed. So that's how you encode the system. And here's how I replaced it. So kind of using the same idea, but I replaced the repeater locks just by using hoppers. So here we put basically just a dropper in front, and if I press the button for the one, we shoot an item into the hoppers. If I press another button, then we don't shoot an item in it. And we just quickly unpower the redstone dust line on top. So everything is also shifted over by one. Okay, so if I would put an item in here now, then as you can see, the first comparator gives out a signal, and every time any of the buttons is really entered, then just shift over by one. Alright, of course, I had to also bring the items back, so we also got a hopper line, just bringing the items back to the dropper here in front. So we also gotta decode the information again, because currently you can't read it out from those repeaters alone. And that's why we have this AND gate basically. So depending on the state you want, you either put a redstone torch for the inversion of the signal or a repeater on the side. And the goal is to have all of the torches and repeaters here to be off. So if I just send any signal in here, which isn't the correct code, then at least one of the torches or the repeaters would turn on, powering this line. And only if all the the inputs are correct, this line would be unpowered. Then later we also combine three of those lines. So this would be the line for number one. Then we have another line right next to it for number two, etc. So that's what Seth Bling used. And also need to decode the information of the hoppers somehow. And I thought it would be an interesting idea to use leaves for that. So the new leafstone mechanic, which was added in Minecraft 1.13. So here the idea is, if we have the correct code, then the pistons push away all the locks from the leaves. And if I would send a signal through the leaves, then we get an output at the end. If the code is not encoded correctly, say we put an item in here, then one of the locks is pulled up, and then if we put a try to send a signal through, we don't get an output at the other end. Alright, and just a technicality, I had to do it like this, because the next line of hoppers was right next to it. So here I used those pistons with observer in order to power the lock, the pistons that push the locks. This would have been much easier if we would just place the piston either one higher or lower to encode the signal. But then we have the issue that I had to use redstone blocks because I restricted myself to not using any redstone dust in order to keep the hoppers locked. And those redstone blocks would also power the quasi-connectivity power the pistons here, so the more elegant solution for the problem by powering the pistons that push the locks directly wasn't possible because I had to use the redstone blocks, as you can see here. So in order to quickly depower the line of hoppers, just pull up the redstone blocks in combination with those slime blocks here and push it down again, and that makes the item shift over by one. Alright, just want to explain you why this is the more complicated way, because I just couldn't put the pistons there, unfortunately. Alright, that's basically how this combo lock works. The rest of my contraption was working around some of the issues that arose by not using redstone dust. Because redstone dust is quite awesome for logic, because it keeps things powered directly. Unlike the other wire systems we have in the game now, you could use leaves or also rails in order to transfer signal in a wire-like structure, but it doesn't keep things powered. That's why, for example, we have the issue if something with the state of the leaves changes here, we always get an output, even if you don't want it. So basically shift one over, then locks get moved around and you would get an output. Now what I did in order to solve the issue is basically restrict the time at which we can get an output. Basically put a non-movable block in front of the piston, and now it doesn't matter what happens now, then remove the non-movable block again, and at the end we send a signal through to check if all the locks are lower. So that's what I basically did over here with this mechanic. So here we have another lock block that is getting pulled down and pushed up again. after a certain delay. So basically here for an observer chain for delay. So once everything with the pistons here has been processed, then we send a signal through. And meanwhile, we extend those pistons here that prevent those pistons from extending. As you can see here, the output of the leaves is this observer chain that powers the piston, and at the beginning we keep those locked. You can actually quickly try to press a button so we can see that in action. You can see this is getting locked, and then we got the quick check, and if all of the signals are sent through, then this ray line is depowered and this block and lock is pushed over. Here we use the leaves as a wire again and get a signal here that pushes up the composter, turns on the comparator, which directly powers the door. So I entered the code already, except the last digit. Just want to show you what's happening if you enter the right code. So now all the redstone blocks are getting pushed up. We get the output because the complete line was unpowered. The blocks are pushed over, composter goes up, and door opens. So I also added a little extra mechanic. We, at the beginning of each button input, we also push back the lock just to unpower it again. All right, let's see this in action. So that's how we close the door again without keeping anything powered directly. So in my system, if you want to change the code or program in the first place, all you gotta do is enter the code that you want, and then make sure that none of the locks touch the leaves. So in this case, it would need to break this lock, move it lower, break all of those locks and move it one lower, etc. Alright, so this was the comparison between old school redstone and using some of the new techniques. Obviously, it would be even better if you would combine all the options we have. Alright, hope you found this interesting. Thanks so much for watching. See you in our next video. Bye bye.